Bitch, let me tell you something. I'm on my way to Columbia. I have to tell y'all a whole story time, but my Uber is right outside. And through this video, I'm gonna be giving y'all a few tips and tricks to have luxurious experiences traveling without breaking the bank too much, okay? Rule number one, call an Uber. Get somebody to take you to the airport. Parking at the airport is expensive as fuck, okay? There was a lot of noise going on. I'm in the baggage claim area, and this is the best area that I found to do videos. Do not spend hell of a lot of money on your flight. You don't need to be in business class, first class. You don't need $1,000 flight. You don't need an expensive ass flight to fly from Florida to New York. You don't need that. Maybe if you're flying like 16, 17 hours internationally to like other countries, you want comfort, but you do not have to spend that type of money on a flight to get to somewhere domestic or for 3-4 hours. Spend the least money on your whole trip, on your actual flight. Put that money into your hotel. Put that money into your excursions, your outfits. Don't put all that money into the plane, because you're only going to be on the plane for maybe 3-4 hours of the trip. People talk a lot of shit about Spirit. A lot of those people that talk shit about Spirit don't ever get to go no place. If you got to take Spirit to go to where your dream vacation place, take Spirit. Just read the website, read the rules, so you're not fucked over. A lot of the shit people complain about is written in the fine print when you're booking your flight on Spirit. Spirit is not a bad airline. Book Frontier, American, Spirit. These are all airlines that get a lot of bad rep because people just want to sound elite and cool. If you got to take Spirit so that you could travel to New York or to Cali or your dream place, take Spirit. Just read the fine line. Make sure that you are arriving a little bit earlier with Spirit. You get what you pay for. I've flown Spirit for most of the places I've been, and I've been freaking everywhere. Don't let you not want to take Spirit or whatever the hell, keep you from going to the places that you dream of going. Because by the time you get there, live it up. So what, you have to take low class? It is what it is. When it comes down to your trip, arrive to the airport 2 hours before your boarding time, not the departure, because they close the gates about 20 minutes before the departure. You need to arrive before your boarding time, so when you have your boarding pass, it will say departure time, gate opens, boarding time. Pay attention to the boarding time, because that's the time that you need to be at the plane. Lines for check-in, lines for security can get long, especially in the morning, especially for international flights. So when you are coming in, you do want to be here 2.5 to 3 hours early. I always say rule of thumb is 2, but I also tell you how that got me fucked up yesterday in a whole nother story time about this damn trip to Colombia that I'm vlogging, but it is what it is. If you can, buy this right here. This is called a luggage weigher. This is very helpful, because you don't want to be that person in the front of the check-in line taking shit out your suitcase and stuffing it into your purse or your backpack or your carry-on. Make sure that you look at the weight limit for your airline and follow it. Make sure your bag is underweight at home. Here's why I say underweight. Give yourself about 5 pounds of leniency, because we like to shop. This sounds crazy. I don't know what the science is. But your shit always weighs, even if you bring the same shit and put the same shit back, your shit always winds up weighing way more when you leave to come back home versus when you departure. I don't understand what that is, but that always seems to happen. Do not have a heavy ass carry-on. I have my backpack here with me. Don't have a heavy ass carry-on. You're gonna hate yourself so much if you have to lug around heavy ass carry-ons. I see people all the time with 3 and 4 bags looking like, bag lady, you gonna hurt your back. They look so stupid with all these bags because they taking shit out that heavy ass suitcase of theirs and stuffing their bags. I've done it before when I was moving from New York to Houston. I've done that before, but it's not ideal. That whole time period in my life is not ideal, but that's not ideal. Make sure your carry-on is a feasible weight. Also, here's another great tip. Do not lay your shit anywhere without washing it. people at the airport, people who just come in here, take people's bags. It'd be people that's not even going on trips that be at the airport, just being here. You never want to leave your shit unattended because people will take your shit. If you lose something at the airport, lost and found or whatever, does not really exist. If you lose some shit at the airport, it's just gone. But really, do not leave your shit unattended at the airport. Keep your shit with you at all times. At the airport, don't try to dress to impress. Don't have a whole bunch of thunder shades, high heels, strappy happy outfits. Don't do the most, because when you go through that security, you gotta take all that shit off and put it back on. Bring a pair of socks if you don't want to be walking on the floor barefoot. But don't be trying to dress doing too much. Wear you some sweats, some jeans, or something, a t-shirt. Wear a reasonable outfit, because don't nobody hate a person more than the person that's waiting at the end of the little conveyor belt to get their shit, more than a person that's standing there trying to get dressed. Be conservative. Try not to wear a whole bunch of jewelry and a whole bunch of stuff. You don't need it. Just dress as plain as possible, a hoodie, and get on your plane. Also, you guys, speaking of security, when they say grab your shit and go to the sitting area, don't be that person getting dressed at the end of the conveyor belt. Grab your shit and go to the bench and then get dressed there. Hold up the line, and it's just so stupid.
Bitch, boy, I wanna stay.